We've seen a couple of interesting move changes. It was what, last month there were several streamers that announced that they had reached an agreement with Twitch that they were going to remain on the platform for the next X amount of years, somewhere between I think 2 to 3 years for most people. Big streamers like Baru, Dr. Lupo, and the Tatman, I think.
Yeah, you're right. But a lot of these guys are under the same agency, so that makes perfect sense. I mean, you could follow the breadcrumbs in the agencies.
Lyric, okay, yeah. So, I mean, this is obviously a direct consequence of what happened with Ninja moving to Mixer, like 100%. Like, Twitch was like, Twitch needed to make a move and keep, like, streamers on. If I was a big streamer, I would leverage what was happening at that time. I'd be like, oh, Ninja's moving. Well, let me see if Mixer has an offer. Oh, Mixer has this offer. Hey, Twitch, can you give me a better deal than this? Like, otherwise I'm leaving. Like, I think a lot of these streamers use what happened to get themselves like a deal where I think some of them would probably have stayed anyways, but.
But if somebody takes, let's say you're making 10 times what you're making right now, theoretically, what you're making right now for this, times it by 10 for a year. Hand that paper over to another company, and that company says, we'll pay you double this, and you can continue to get sub revenue and whatever else we can offer on our website. Are you not going to take that? I would take that.
Oh, I'm not saying that's a bad thing at all. No question. No, I mean, it's a smart thing.
I'm not implying that. I'm just saying that, like, they're finding that work-life balance. Like, Ninja, everybody's like, oh, look at his viewer numbers. Look how low he is. Ninja's signing TV deals, toy deals, everything else. He's going and putting his face on bigger things than Twitch will. I don't want to say Twitch will ever be, but you can only reach so high on Twitch. Mm-hmm. Like the people that we know who are super duper famous, you go say their name on the street and people are like, who's this?
That and you know, surface like, numbers just aren't as, perpetually on all sides of this, focus on the wrong metrics, but just on the wrong things.
Right, and that's value. The thing is, this is the justification of that. This is the realignment of that. They're getting their money, they're able to continue to market their brand. They're continuing to have that anonymity or I'm trying to use a big word and I forget it, but they're trying to have their brand and be able to market it, but they're also getting their work-life balance back. They're being able to make more money. They're being able to brand outside. And all they have to do is sign with a company where when you click on OBS, all you have to do is change the NZS server. That's it. It's literally a checkbox on our server to go from YouTube to Twitch to, you know, to Mixer. And sure, we were talking about this earlier as well. Patreon. You look at the culture differences on Mixer and YouTube and Twitch. And the biggest thing that I noticed, that, at least from somebody who tried it out on YouTube, was the biggest culture shift is chat. Chat is dramatically different when you go from Twitch to Mixer to YouTube. But otherwise, as a broadcaster, it's really not all that different. So if your broadcast is like a Ninja where chat is just there, and you're like a Shroud where chat is just there, you can't do much else with it. You're just changing where you go, but you're getting a bigger check for it. So it's a no-brainer.
Additional services like, you know, on Mixer, like what Sparks do. Like, I don't know what some of
those. Yeah, Sparks are just what now Twitch is rolling out currency, but then Sparks have some donation aspect to it, and they've evolved.
It's all like surface minor modifications. The core qualities are still the exact same.